We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Washington Nationals and the Texas Rangers. A big-time arm and a power bat should be fun. First pitch is next. Kyle Gibson gets the starting assignment for Texas in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that is a little bit up and down throughout points of his career. A career ERA just over 4. When he's good, he can be really good. And when he's bad, well, let's just say he can be pretty bad at times. But it'll be interesting to see which one we see. He's a little bit of Jekyll and Hyde. Hopefully he's going to be a little bit more Jekyll than Hyde in this one here today.
First of 3 is underway on this Tuesday night as the opening pitch is taken for ball 1. And fellas, you take a look at this Rangers team entering play here tonight. They come into this one fresh off a victory last time out that ended a 6-game losing streak.
Yeah, Maddie, it was nice to see. This team hadn't been playing well. They've been on a recent losing streak and able to win their last game just relaxes everybody. Let's see if they continue that trend today.
Game time temperature tonight, a comfortable 66 degrees at first pitch. Two and one, the count to Trey Turner.
2 balls, 1 strike.
And this will miss as well, so he's in danger of losing the leadoff man here tonight. It's 3-1 now. The pitch. And he lays off ball 4, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this happening. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
In now is Adam Eaton. Career against Kyle Gibson, he's a 333 hitter. He's taken him deep once. First pitch coming, here it is.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the corners if you're not throwing strikes consistently.
Two and oh to the Nationals center fielder.
Pick your poison in this situation right here. I know that runner on first is certainly affecting his mechanics, but now you're down 2-0 and you got to find a way to get back in the strike zone.
Has a look, now the pitch. That one's in there on the black, 2-1. And set up working the plate is Larry Bullard, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
Hey, behind the dish, D-Row, Larry Bullard. Pretty standard guy, works. The only problem, I think, at times, hitters have a little bit difficult time. He'll give a little bit on that inside corner and outside corner. Not very consistent.
Yeah, but Larry's approachable. That's the one thing. If you keep...
And hold on there. That's not going to get him in there with the stolen base. Turner leads off second with nobody out. Outside and a full count, 3-2. Waiting on deck is Howie Kendrick. Now the payoff pitch home. Grounded to the right. Scooped up. And it's a productive first out as that runner's able to advance 90 feet up to third here.
That is third. The second baseman, Howie Kendrick.
Striding in now for the Nats, Howie Kendrick. First trip to the plate for him in this one, and it's a good RBI spot, too. Leadoff man at third with one down. He's set. Here it comes. And he lays off there, 1-0. Count even now at 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
As a veteran out on the mound, that's a pitch that you expect to get a call on. Got to believe he keeps pounding that spot until he builds a rapport with the umpire.
Popped up. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. A man at third with one away. A line shot to third base, but the runner is back to avoid the double play.
That is four. The left fielder, number 22, Juan Soto.
Here now is Juan Soto, hitless in four tries in the ball game yesterday. First offering on its way.
Nope.
Trying to work that slider to the outer half, but it misses 1-0. The ball and no strikes. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
With the runner on third, two outs, base open, and a good hit at the plate, you have to be smart and not give in. If you walk this guy, so what? It's a lot worse if you give him a ball that he can hurt you on.
And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. Two outs here with a runner at third. Count even at 2-2. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. One left for Washington, and now the Rangers will get their shot in a scoreless ball game. Patrick Corbin will be on the mound for the series opener. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
All the way back from Tommy John surgery, this guy's a really good pitcher. There are a lot of teams in baseball that would love to have him in their rotation. Not an overpowering fastball, but a good one. 89 to 93 miles an hour. Slider, without a doubt, his best off-speed pitch. And if he's throwing strikes with that slider, look out. He can shut any team down.
Coming to the plate now, Elvis Andrus. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And that misses ball one. So, guys, these Nationals, as they interplay here tonight, they come in the midst of a stretch where they've dropped six of their last nine.
Yeah, Matty, everyone always looks at the schedule, and these cross-country trips can be a bear. I always looked at him with a smile on my face. 5 hours in the plane with the boys, playing some cards, really coming together. I feel like that's where the chemistry of the team really starts to take shape on those long cross-country trips. Let's see how this team plays today.
Too tight with that one. 3-0. Three and one.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
Here it comes now to Andrus. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
Batting second, the right fielder, Hunter.
So next to the plate for Texas, Hunter Cole. He'll get to take his first cuts here. From the belt, the pitch. A runner at first with no outs here. Ground ball left side. Cabrera's there. Kendrick on to Zimmerman, and they get them both.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Willie Calhoun.
And ready for his first at-bat, Willie Calhoun. And he's a guy that's really scuffling at the plate right now. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. First pitch is a slider down low. It's 1-0. Bases are empty here with two men out. Out of play off to the right. Now the 1-1 pitch. It is a sharp slider taken low for a ball. Strike two, swinging just out in front of the slider. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Rangers go down quickly there. Still no score. And now for Washington, Eric Thames, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
Eric Thames.
Now here's the pitch.
Count 1-0.
The 1-0. Is an off-speed pitch taken for a ball. And he gets the slider over here. It's 2-1 now. Ball three as the sinker misses just off the black that time.
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
The 3-1.
Ooh, that's a good pitch to take a hack at right there. Change up, up in the zone. He'd like to have that one back.
Fouled away. The next 3-2. And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
And don't forget, he lost his last time out, so he wants to get off on the right foot here. The last thing he wanted was to walk the leadoff man.
So striding forward now, Kurt Suzuki. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. From the stretch. In the air now, out to left. Gallo will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
That is seven. The designated hitter, Starlin.
So here's Starlin Castro. He's assuming the role of DH in this interleague matchup.
Yeah, Matt, that's one of the funny things about National League teams playing in AL ballparks. All of a sudden, the lineup kind of changes dramatically. But the cool thing is it gets more guys a chance to get some at-bats or time in the field.
First pitch coming. Here it is. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Gallo will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning.
Batting it, the third baseman, number 13, Asdrubal Cabrera.
Here now is Asdrubal Cabrera. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Ball one.
He'll start him with a sinker here, but that sinks a bit too much that time. It's 1-0. Still looking for our first hit in the ball game.
Oh, 2-0. He's going to have a talk with the umpire after this half inning.
Because if he's not going to get those calls, he's got to come a little bit more over the heart of the plate. And that usually means damage done.
Liner toward right center. Cole is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Nationals leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Last half of the second set to go. So that brings up the big bat of Joey Gallo. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Two and oh the count to the Rangers left fielder. High and away, not close. 3-0.
Well, he was definitely looking fastball here, and he got one. But that was good discipline to lay off and get himself into a 3-0 count.
3-1.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
The 3-1 pitch is in there for a full count now, 3-2. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Stepping into the box, Robinson Chirinos. And there's a look at his home and road splits so far this year. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. There's a good breaking ball as it gets the bottom of the zone. From the belt, kicks and deals.
1-1.
Slider laid off for a ball. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
High in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. The 2-2. Danny Santana is on deck. Hit on the ground out to short. Throw pulls the first baseman off the bag.
And that play is indicative of how their entire season has gone so far. They make the routine plays difficult, and if there's a tough play, they really struggle with it. They need to tighten up their fundamentals so they can get back on track.
Now to the plate, Danny Santana. He went 2-for-4 to close out Sunday's series finale. First offering on its way. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. A ball and a strike. Santana, playing here in his age 29 season, he's a veteran of 7 years at the major league level. 1-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late, and you can't even put a good swing on it.
None out, runners at first and second. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. And another foul ball. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three.
He put up a pretty good battle at the plate right there. They finally get him on a 1-2 pitch, but you could see that he wasn't laying down without a fight. He really made the pitcher earn that strikeout.
Here's Todd Frazier now, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Not close, it's 2-0. Frazier, or the Todd Father as he's affectionately called. He was a first round pick back in the draft of 2007.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on the superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go in the high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
He's set. Here's the 3-0. Now a check swing, but it's strike one anyway, says the home plate umpire. Bottom of the second here with no score. And the count will be full. Working for the punch out and the offering, and it's fouled away. The 3-2 one more time. Now a fastball. Oh, strike three called on a pitch that looked inside. Instead, it's out number two.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
So here's the left-handed bat of Rougned Odor. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. The set and the 1-0.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Two balls and a strike.
Count is two and one.
Here's the 2-1.
Hey. Two balls, two strikes.
Coming up now on 30 pitches in the inning. And this is swung on and missed as the 30th pitch of this inning finally does the trick. The side is retired. Rangers leave a pair. We'll move to the third with no score. T. top of the third set to get underway. Set to get his evening at the plate started, Ryan Zimmerman. And it's been a real struggle for him with the bat so far this year, looking to get things turned around in a hurry. First delivery to him on the way.
Nope.
Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. And this winds up inside for a ball. 2-0 now.
Sometimes it can be difficult for a pitcher. You're facing a guy that's not known to be a big stick in the lineup. Sometimes the toughest thing is to be aggressive and throw strikes.
3-0 now.
Just a little bit off to start the third now. That's three straight balls.
And that's over. 3-1. Shot to second base and handled for the first out. And with that, let's take a moment to show you what's happening in the American League's Western Division. At the plate, Trey Turner. He worked a walk to open up the ball game. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Lays off 1-0. Sinker stays outside and is behind now 2-0. Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. Too tight with that one. 3-0. Adam Eaton is on deck. The 3-0 pitch. And he lost him here on four pitches. So a speed merchant is aboard now with one away.
Well, in a scoreless game, you want to do anything you can to jumpstart your offense. With the speed of this guy on first, don't be surprised if he gets the green light here.
Stepping in, Adam Eaton. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And he has to dive, but he's back in easily. First pitch on its way.
1-0.
And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. Nationals have yet to crack the hit column thus far. A wave and a miss at the 2-0 sinker. 2-1.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Lifted the other way to left center. Left fielder is on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now batting the second baseman, Howie Kendrick.
So it's a runner at first with two gone, and stepping in is the second baseman, Howie Kendrick. Kendrick waiting. Now the pitch. Liner towards second. And there's the first hit of the game for the Nats. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
The left fielder, number 22, Juan Soto.
Juan Soto to the plate now as he'll take a look at a sinker here too low for ball one. Two on, two out for him here in the third. A little late on this one as it's lifted the other way down the left field line. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Nats leave a pair. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Up next for the Rangers, Ronald Guzman. Man, he's a guy really in need of something to click at the plate right now. It's been a rough go for him. First pitch coming. Here it is. In there at the knees as he offers a strike to the leadoff man. Nothing and one. One and one. Swing and a miss on a pitch outside. One and two now.
This lineup is flailing right now. They're having a hard time just making contact, let alone putting the ball in play.
A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
Boy, he's really on a roll of the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side in the last inning, and now he picks up right where he left off by striking off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
So the base is empty here with one away, and it's back to the top of the lineup now for Elvis Andrus. Here it comes now to Andrus. And this one runs up high, ball one. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. And that misses low and inside. Two balls and no strikes.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches. And when he's getting the ball in the zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
3-0 to him now. And now pitch on the way.
Now that's a really curious pitch selection. 3-0 and turned to the slider. You have to wonder if maybe he's lost the feel for his fastball.
Rangers still searching for hit number one in the ballgame. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch outs and working on number five.
Boy, and they cannot touch him right now. Five straight strikeouts on the ledger, and there are two away.
He's looked great on the bump the first few innings of this game, and I think his ability to change speeds effectively has been a big reason why. That was a good change of speed for the strikeout there, and I've seen a lot of hitters look pretty off with their timing so far.
At the plate now, Hunter Cole. He grounds it sharply to third. Throw in time, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. All set for the start of the fourth. Now at the plate, Eric Thames. He drew a walk his first time up.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings. With no score, you'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. And he misses low with it, 2-0.
They obviously circled him before the game that they were not going to let him beat them. Walked him his first time up, and now they're nibbling again.
Yanked high and deep down the line in right. And it's a foul ball. Sent foul again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2.
Now the pitch. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
Just tied him up with that last pitch. Pretty evident by the swing. Sometimes guys get in that protect mode so much that they're swinging at everything that they see, and they end up offering at pitches that they can't possibly do anything with.
At the plate, Kurt Suzuki. As he'll take a look at ball one. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball, 1-1. Suzuki, a 36-year-old veteran, is second in the league in all-star voting among closers, so it looks promising that he'll get an invite to the midseason festivities.
Yeah, and he's been having an excellent season to date, making a push towards that all-star game. Hey, fans, get out there and vote. This guy sits in second place, but I'm sure he'd like to be named starter.
Line drive to left. Gallo is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two.
Now batting, designated hitter, Starling Castro.
Here's Starling Castro. So far, 0 for 1 with a flyout. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Sliced hard on the ground. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Nationals gone in order. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. And here's the former prize Dodger prospect, Willie Calhoun. He'll look to get something going here in this scoreless ballgame. First delivery to him on the way. No balls and a strike to count. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. All even now, 2-2. Now here's the pitch.
Helpful.
Joey Gallo will be next. The payoff pitch home. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. And the throw on to first will take care of him. So he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away.
Joey Gallo.
One gone in the Texas fourth. And up to bat next, the left-handed light tower power of Joey Gallo. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch.
1-0.
Ball one. So far this year against southpaws, Gallo is holding on to a batting average way down in the 210s.
Matty, he struggled this season against left-handed pitching, but maybe a little shot of confidence with the manager putting him in the lineup today.
Count now a ball and a strike. And he misses 2-1.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
And and a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Boy, this guy has really good stuff so far on this one. How about seven Ks, and we're just in the middle innings of this one. If he continues this up, this could be a real solid performance.
So now to the plate, Robinson Chirinos, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike.
Quite an interesting outing up to this point as we head into the middle innings. He's pitching quite well, but you look at his first pitch strike percentage, less than 40%. That's going to be something he's going to need to clean up moving forward.
1-1 to Chirinos. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. This is foul right side. One and two, here it comes. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance, but that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall. The throw is wild and it gets away. And he will make it up to third base, as that is a gift there off of what was a terrible throw.
Not to minimize the hit here, because it was a double all the way, but the wheels kind of came off defensively, and he's on third because of a bad throwing miscue.
Into the box now, Danny Santana, unable to find the zone with the slider, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. That nibbled the corner there, but missed, 2-1. The set and the 2-1. And it's two balls and two strikes now. That pitch was so slow it barely registered on the radar gun.
Yeah, Matt, we don't see too many pitches crawling to the plate like that, especially these days. That can be a really tough pitch for a hitter to wait back on.
And it's three balls and two strikes to the Rangers center fielder.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ball game, and that one ends the inning. Rangers leave one through four, still tied, nothing. Welcome back to Arlington. Before we get much further, let's check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together.
They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Ready for another chance as Drubal Cabrera hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0.
Well, that's a nasty breaking ball right there. Backdoor slider, just missed the corner. As they say, that's a Hall of Fame pitch.
2-0 now. No 3-0 now.
Not the way you'd like to start this fifth inning, falling behind 3-0 on the count. It's about time he starts throwing some strikes.
And the pitch. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Digging in, Ryan Zimmerman hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
This is when you start to lose your mind a little bit. You know you're in a slump as you walk to the plate. You finally do something good and barrel something up, and it's right at somebody.
Too low, 1-0. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs.
Here we go, guys. Come on.
And he misses again, 2-0.
He's certainly searching out there on the mound. Five straight balls in a row. You have to take a strike as a hitter right here.
Ready with the 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. Trey Turner will be next. Now here's a check swing, and they appeal down to first. No swing, so that's ball four. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Trey Turner. It was a walk in his last trip. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. No runs, just one hit and two errors on the Washington line score. Oh, and he's got him in the palm of his hand now. It's 0-2. Oh, a double play ball to second. Four. And he'll get in there safely.
Oh, this is kind of unforgivable for the second baseman. He tries to square himself to the throw to second to start the double play. And I'm not sure what happened next. Maybe his cleats got stuck, or maybe he just lost the grip. But the net result is E4 with two men on board.
Bases full now following the error. And standing in is the veteran outfielder, Adam Eaton. It comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Left side, but well foul.
Pitcher on the mound has to find a way to minimize damage right here. Got to believe he's willing to trade two outs for a run.
Bases loaded here, nobody out. And a check swing here, but he pretty clearly broke the plane, and it's 0-2 now. Working for the punch out and the offering. Oh, now a line drive, and he's not going to have a play on it. And right, this ball gets down for extra bases. As he arrives at second without a play, as they take the lead with two runs scoring on the play.
Well, maybe the tables have turned a bit. Earlier in the game, the pitcher had his way with him, but he wins the battle this time, and in a big way. Two runs on the board as a result.
Here's Howie Kendrick, as he'll watch a slider that stays inside for ball one. The 1-0 home takes this the other way to right. That's in there, base hit. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score.
Hey, with that base hit right now, the lead's 3-0. And the way their pitcher's going, D-Row, that might hold up in this one.
Yeah, and you're well aware of it, Dan, as an offense, just trying to put those extra runs across the board. You can take a look at the guy on the slab, toeing the slab. He's on fire right now.
Colby Allard will come on in relief here and appear in game number 25 on the year so far.
Colby Allard.
In now, Juan Soto. He swings and grounds it to short. There's one, and it's in time to get him, but they do play to run on the play.
Gotta love that out of your reliever, right? The first batter he faces, he gets to roll over into a double play. Pulled the right string that time, Skip.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and in steps the lefty power threat, Eric Thames. Here's the first pitch to him. And he fouls this one off. Thames, formerly property of the Milwaukee Brewers, he became a member of this team after signing as a free agent earlier this season.
Yeah, he didn't have an opportunity to really get acclimated to this ball club. Showing up during a season is not always easy, opening the doors to a big league clubhouse and trying to get to know your teammates. The best way to get to know them is to go out and produce.
Four runs here in this half inning. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
I like that he tried to tie him up inside on that pitch, but it was a little bit of a risky situation because if you're off just a little bit, you can end up plunking a guy. That's the last thing you want to do when you've got a guy 0-2.
Two balls and two strikes now. 2-2. Popped him up. Frazier in foul ground, and no one will track it down. Four runs, only three hits, and two errors on the Washington line score. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Line toward right center, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
The catcher, number 28, Kurt Suzuki.
Standing in now, Kurt Suzuki. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. He's 0-for-2 in the ball game so far. Pitch well above the letters with the fastball that time. Two out with the man at first. And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss.
Boy, what a time to pull the string on him. On 2-0, there's no way anyone's thinking changeup. So if you can locate it, that's pretty much unhittable.
The 2-1. Pops this one up. And that's in there. Base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
Boy, after that base knock right there, D-Roll, he extends his hitting streak to 7 games.
Yeah, and you can tell he's made some necessary adjustments at the plate. Anytime you're getting a knock every day of the week, you're doing things right. He's keeping that front shoulder tucked, staying inside the ball, not trying to do too much.
Sends that one out of play for strike one. And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. Runners at the corners, two men out. Hit on the ground to third. Frazier is there. Little pitch and catch chance for Odor at second base, and that'll do it. Nine men come to the plate, four score. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Nationals 4 and the Rangers nothing. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with the Rangers manager during the inning break about the team's offensive production to this point. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. He said it seems like every at-bat has gone deep into the count, which has resulted in a really high pitch count for their opponent. We checked the numbers. So far, they've worked a total of 6 full counts. Guys?
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Digging in, Todd Frazier. He'll lead things off as we begin the home fifth.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going. And the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
And a layoff fastball here in a good spot, but ruled the ball 1-0. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 1-0 home. Fouled off. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Again, another foul ball. High in the air into shallow left center. Soto comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for route number one. So still nothing against him on the scoreboard here in the fifth as we check out the league leaderboard for team ERA. And you can see that these guys are, as we speak, fourth in the NL in that category. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the second baseman, Rougned Odor. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2. And Dan, that's a pretty good example of why he's such a great pitcher.
Yeah, stuff. Stuff is obviously the important key to being dominant on the mound. But it doesn't mean a whole lot if you don't have outstanding control to go along with it. But he does, and he really spotted that pitch.
One out, nobody on. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
I'll tell you, he looks really dialed in on the bump right there. He's got a shutout going, and he really seems to have this lineup off balance. Even when he challenges them up in the zone, they don't have an answer for it.
Stepping in now, Ronald Guzman, as he comes up empty on a pitch right down the middle for strike one. Two out, nobody on. And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1. And it's 1-2.
Man, he's in control of all his weapons right here. One strike away from 5 shutout innings.
Little too much bite on the slider that time, taken outside. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over. Rangers set down in order. They trail here 4-0. So stepping in, Asdrubal Cabrera. He'll lead things off in the Washington sixth.
Asdrubal Cabrera.
Come on down. Here's the first pitch to him. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. On the ground up the middle. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
Dan, I'll tell you, it doesn't matter what it looks like right there. That lawn dart felt so good.
Oh, Devo, this guy's been due. He really needed that one.
Here's Ryan Zimmerman now, as he'll take a changeup here for strike one. 0 for 1 with a run scored thus far. Oh and one, here it comes. Popped him up. Chirinos shading to his right, and that's the first out of the inning.
The batter, number 7, shortstop, Trey Turner.
Here now is Trey Turner. He reached on an error and later scored his last time up. First pitch of the at bat on its way.
At the ball. Hold on, no strike.
Now the 1-0.
2-0.
And that's taken for a strike on the inside corner. 2-1.
That's an impressive pitch right there. If you're willing to throw a changeup on 2-0, that tells me that's a pitch you feel really confident with.
The 2-1 home. Now a little pop up off toward the first base side. Guzman is over and he tucks it away for the second out.
Now batting the center fielder, Adam Eaton.
Striding in, Adam Eaton. He drove in 2 runs on a double in his last at bat.
Yeah, give me a repeat performance of that last double. With a man on first right now, let him run, get you a ribby.
He's set, and the pitch.
Ball inside. Come on, Blue.
A runner on first with 2 away.
Come on, man.
2-0 now. Three and oh now.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
The 3-0 pitch.
Hey.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball 4. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with 2 away.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with 2 outs. And now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Digging in and looking for more, Howie Kendrick. So far, 2 for 3 in this one. Kendrick waiting. Now the pitch. Slapped hard the opposite way. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. He pulls into second safely as a run will score on the play as well.
He was not messing around in that at bat. Looking for a first pitch fastball all the way, and that's exactly what he got. Nice job to rip it down the line and drive in a run at the same time. He'll feel good about that one.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Juan Soto. He hits here in a spot where he might be able to put this one out of reach.
Yeah, Matt, down five, another run across here could very well put the nail in the coffin. Mentally, they might still feel like they've got a shot if they could get out of this jam, though.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Here's a ball skied in the air near the line, back behind first. Guzman has got it, and the side is retired. One for the Nationals on the RBI double. On to the bottom of the sixth. It's the Nationals 5 and the Rangers nothing. So Elvis Andrus, the next to bat, will start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've been completely overmatched to this point. One hit through five innings. I mean, what else can you say about the pitching they faced other than it's been fantastic? We'll see if that continues as we approach the later inning.
Now here's the pitch. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. Here it comes now to Andrus. Down the first baseline. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
The batter, the right fielder, Hunter Cole.
Settling in now, Hunter Cole. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. First pitch coming, here it is.
If he's able to locate that two seamer down at the knees, he's going to get a ton of swing and miss and a ton of ground balls today.
At the ball one.
After watching that one go by and a ball being called, you can rest assured he knows he's not getting away with another one of those. I guarantee you he's going to be aggressive on this next pitch.
A ball and two strikes now.
Wow, that was an ugly swing right there, and that tells us all we need to know. Nobody's picking the baseball up off this guy.
A little low, it's 2-2. And through 5 1/3, already coming up on 100 pitches here.
Yeah, Matty V, this pitch count continues to go up, 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 near 100 pitches here. He's not even through the sixth inning. And Mark DeRosa, this is right where you'd like to have a pitcher like this guy.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of stress pitches for him, you know. Usually you can throw 100 pitches, and if you're not taxed and there's not people in runners in scoring position, you could be all right. But he's had to grind this one.
So it was a swinging strike three. Hunter Cole goes down for the second out here in the bottom half. Into the box, Willie Calhoun. As he'll swing at the first pitch and bang one into right center field, that's a base hit.
Yeah, man, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
Next to bat will be the Texas cleanup hitter, Joey Gallo. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
First pitch on its way.
1-0.
This is why pitching is so difficult. You're cruising along to give up a hit. Now you've got to lock in and get this middle part of the order done.
Two out with the man at first. Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1.
Well, he's following the code not to miss down and into a lefty. Everything on the outer half of the plate.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
Very impressive outing so far. His command has been spot on. Even when he misses his spot, it isn't out over the heart of the plate. He's throwing quality pitches.
From the belt, the pitch.
Oh, that's out.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Well, he made quick work of the first two guys this half inning, getting two quick outs. But then he gives up a base hit and now the walk. We'll see if he has it in him to draw the line in the sand and get out of this.
From the belt, the pitch. Robinson Chirinos is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1.
It's really hard to work deep in the games when you're having an outing like this guy is. You're going to strike out a lot of guys. Well, guess what? Your pitch count's going to go up too.
The 0-1 pitch. Hit high and deep to left field. Back on it is the left fielder. To the track, to the wall. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, number 14 on the season, and it's a 5-3 game now.
An elite starter, you don't know if you're even going to get wood on the baseball today.
You know, and that'll rattle you a little bit. This guy's been throwing the ball great, one of the top pitchers in the game. He's not used to guys barreling him up and hitting him in the seats.
On his way out to the mound now, the Washington manager, and we're going to see a pitching change as that's going to do it for his starter here tonight. So his final ledger will show just 5 2/3 innings of work, but he did what he needed to do in this one. Austin Voth, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Number 50, Austin Voth.
At the plate now, Danny Santana. Batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. 0-2 for him to this point. And this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike.
Hey, a two-out walk right here would be the tying run to the plate. Even though it's early on, you got a guy on deck that has a lot of pop.
Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Here's a little chopper up the middle. He's got it. Throw not nearly in time as he reaches it first.
And that's great hustle right there out of the box. Not everybody's getting it right out of the chute from step one, but I have to ask you, Dan, how frustrating executing a pitch and there's an infield knock.
It is, D-Roy, and you can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that that ball is going to be hit on the ground, and you're thinking deep down inside, okay, there's a quick out, and it just wasn't meant to be.
Here comes the first pitch. Todd Frazier is in for the third time as he looks at a ball high. It's 1-0. From the stretch. Slow little grounder left side. Taken there by Cabrera. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit and the side is retired. But the Rangers post a three spot, all coming on the three-run home run. The 5, 6, and 7 hitters to start the seventh. It's the Nationals 5 and the Rangers 3. New inning set to get underway. Now in the box, Eric Thames. He steps in off a base hit in his last at bat.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. But pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot.
Swing and a miss as he was way in front of that one. Low and inside with the breaking ball as that causes him to back up a bit.
Well, this team, they're swinging at everything, but that pitch was just a little too far out of the strike zone.
A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Swing and a hard liner to center field. Santana is right there, one down.
The catcher, number 28, Kurt Suzuki.
In now, Kurt Suzuki. He singled his last time up. Here's the first pitch to him.
Off the plate, ball one.
The 1-0 home. Still 1-2. Here it comes. Swing and he pops him up. And no one can get there. He'll try it again. One and two, here it comes. Fouled away. Still a ball and two strikes.
Hey, five foul balls in a row. Loving the battle in the box right here, making the pitcher work.
The 1-2. A shot down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2.
Six fouls in a row. This is turning into one of those epic at-bats. Who's going to blink first? Is the pitcher going to continue to attack the zone, or is the hitter going to come outside it?
The 1-2. High and deep down the left field line. And no one will get this one.
Are you serious right here? This is becoming a joke. Eight foul balls in a row. This guy is in auto swing mode. This pitcher could throw this thing anywhere, and he's pulling the trigger on it.
And even 2-2 count to the Nationals catcher. Now here it comes. Popped into the air, back behind second. Odor is under it. He's got it, and there are two down now.
The batter, the designated hitter, Starling Castro.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Starling Castro. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Now the pitch. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Now here's the pitch.
Boy, his pitch count has really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
The 3-1. Swing and a liner, but foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit to short. Andrus fields it cleanly. Throw on to Guzman at first, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for Washington as they hang on to their 5-3 lead. Last half of the seventh here. Now at the plate, Rougned Odor. He went down on strikes last time up.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
Ball one. And it's fouled away. The 1-1. Is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. And he fouls this one off. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. The 2-2. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
And that misses ball four. It's a leadoff walk to start the home seventh.
And that at bat will put a smile on any manager's face. The pitch total of the opposing pitcher just keeps going higher and higher, and he still couldn't put him away. So this inning is off to a good start for the guys carrying the sticks.
Standing in, Ronald Guzman. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. First pitch coming, here it is. Pulled the fastball down a little too much there. That's ball one. Pops it up back behind second base, and Kendrick will make the play on it for the first out.
The batter, number one, shortstop, Elvis Andrew.
So a runner at first now with one away, and it's back to the top of the lineup now for Elvis Andrus. Has a look, now the pitch. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. The 1-0. High in the air and deep to straightaway left. Racing back the left fielder. That one is out of here. This game is tied. It's It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. Fourth home run for him on the season as we are all tied at five.
Time at bat right there. Team trailing and he ties it up with a bomb. Interested to see how this one finishes out.
Into the box now, Hunter Cole. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. He's hitless in three at bats to this point. The 1-0 delivery.
This inning really feels like it's getting away from him out there. As a reliever, you can't let that happen. Nothing you can do about what's already happened, and it's only going to get worse if you're not focusing on the guy in the batter's box.
Outside, 3-0 now. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Grounded up the first baseline, but this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. Swing and a miss, and they come back from a 3-0 count to sit him down on strikes, and there are two gone.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to, and that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
So now to the plate, Willie Calhoun. As he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. A 1-0 delivery. Fouled off. The 1-1 home. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Two out, nobody on. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Hit in the air out to center field. Eaton is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. But two here in the Rangers' half of the inning, and they come on this two-run home run. We'll march on to the eighth, all even at five apiece. Nick Goody has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 41, Nick.
Ready to begin the eighth, stepping in and ready for another shot as Drubal Cabrera. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Here's the first pitch to him. And this is foul tipped at the plate directly off the arm of the home plate umpire. And folks, there's no padding up there. That's going to hurt. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. A bouncer to the left side. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And he'll make it to first easily on what will almost certainly be ruled an infield single.
I know he didn't smoke that one from the offensive standpoint, but you know what? A knock's a knock, especially to lead off an inning. Game tied, and it's getting late. That could prove to be pivotal.
In now, Ryan Zimmerman. As he'll try and hold off the swing, but this one's in there for strike one. The 0-1 pitch. Now the Rangers get a reliever up and throwing in the bullpen as a right-hander's begun to warm up out there. A ball and two strikes. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. Fastball, and oh, he has to bend out of the way of that one.
Most good pitchers know that they have to work inside and sometimes even come off the plate to keep hitters from getting comfortable up there. I think that was part of the intent with that last pitch.
This is on the ground over to first. Andrus on to first, and you can forget about the go-ahead run being on base. He's erased on the double play.
That's one of the hardest double plays to turn right there because of the difficult throw the first baseman has to make. No problem this time, though, and they get the two outs they were looking for.
Base is empty now after the double play. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Trey Turner. He's set. Here it comes. A fastball here, too low. It's 1-0.
Obviously, the game plan wasn't to let this guy beat you right here. He's already walked twice, and that pitch out of the zone tells me they want nothing to do with him.
Here's the 1-0. That one's right down the middle for a strike with the fastball. Bases are empty here with two men out. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. Here's the 2-1.
Outside, that's the ball.
Grounded toward Odor at second. Fielded cleanly on to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Nationals go quietly. This ball game still tied 5-5. Daniel Hudson is going to come on in relief as he'll be making his 20th appearance of the season.
Daniel Hudson.
Here's Joey Gallo now. A couple of walks for him thus far.
Leading off for the Rangers, the left fielder, Joey Gallo.
Here comes the first pitch.
No, inside.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Well, that's ball three, and right now the Rangers would do anything to get that leadoff guy on.
Here it is, the 3-0 is in there for strike one.
Great job of doubling up with a fastball inside. A lot of times you'll see a pitcher go in there, but they won't go back in there a second time. This guy's not afraid to pitch inside.
The 3-1. He was swung on and missed. A full count now.
He was able to sneak that fastball by him on 3-1, so now we've got a battle on our hands.
The 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed, strike three.
It looked like this at bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
Standing in now, Robinson Chirinos. As with one away, he can't make contact on the first pitch. It's strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. Outside for a ball, 1-1. Now the Nats are going to get a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. The 1-1 home. And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. There's a swing and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. The relay. So that'll go into the books as an E6, and he'll be kicking himself over that one. Standing in, Danny Santana will swing it from the left side right here.
One of the things this guy would like to do from the left side is swing it a little bit better against right-handed pitching. This guy has decent numbers, but not great numbers against right-handed pitchers.
First delivery to him on the way.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Here it comes, 0-2. And smart to lay off there as the fastball misses. It's 1-2 now.
Props to the hitter right there for laying off with a guy on third. You want to be aggressive, but you have to get a pitch you can drive.
To two balls and two strikes now.
All right, no more hoping he's going to chase. It's 2-2 now. You've got to come up with the best pitch right here because this is definitely a strikeout situation.
Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. Swing and a miss. That one tied him up. Throw to first. We'll take care of him. Score it 2-3 on the putout, and there are two gone now. At the plate, Todd Frazier, who could really use a knock here, 0-3 in the game so far. From the stretch. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Two and two.
2-2.
Fouled away. Two out, nobody on.
Hey,
high and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. On the eighth pitch of the at bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. So one run here on one hit, one error in the inning, and no one left. We've played eight full. Texas is out in front 6-5. Jesse Chavez comes on from the pen hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 30, Jesse Chavez.
Adam Eaton digging in next.
Leading off for Washington, the center fielder, number 2, Adam Eaton.
Here's the first pitch to him. Drilled down the line, but this is foul for the first strike. The windup and the 0-1. Tries to drag his way on here, but now he's behind 1-2. Swung on in the dirt, strike 3. Chirinos recovers, and he makes the throw to first. Eaton is retired, and there's one away.
You know, professional catchers make those plays look easy most of the time, but that was a big play that shouldn't go unnoticed. Had he found a way on, he would have represented a tying run, so that was a nice job there to make sure that strikeout didn't get wasted.
Into the box now, Howie Kendrick, 3-for-4 so far and seeing it well in this ball game. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Left fielder giving chase. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away.
The left fielder, number 22, Juan Soto.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Juan Soto. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Tying run at the plate, the 0-1. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around first, he's digging for second. And hold all tickets now as the tying run gets into scoring position with a two-out double.
Everyone knows there are no awards for successfully getting 26 outs. You need to get all 27 before you can start celebrating. That two-out double here tonight, putting the equalizer on at second base. A couple of minutes ago, this thing looked like it might be over, but everything can change with one swing of the bat.
And now with the possible tying run at second here, we're going to have a pinched runner as they try to get a little more speed out there. To the plate now, Eric Thames, as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. The set and the 1-0. Downstairs, two balls and no strikes.
Now you can see he's working around this guy right here. Why not? First base is open. Walk wouldn't be the worst thing in this spot.
Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Bounce to first. And he'll step on first for the out, and the ball game is over.
Hey, we were really treated to a good one today. Bottom of the eighth proved to be the difference, though. and a good job here in the ninth to close the book on this one.
And tonight's one-run game comes to an end, 6-5, the final. Texas came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Nick Goody gets the win in relief, his second of the year. Jesse Chavez records the save, his 14th. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, @MLB The Show.